Dear friends, when we were in high school, I was in Mary Help of Christians High School Seminary in my hometown, Binmalay, Pangasinan. We were forced to read books. At the end of the year, we have to reach 30 points. So if we read Hardy Boys, pag fourth year ka na, 1 point na lang yun. You have to read 30 books, Hardy Boys, to complete the 30 points. But if you want higher points, you go to Charles Dickens, you go to Victor Hugo. At isang naalala kong libro na binasa namin is The Silver Chalice by Thomas B. Costain. Alala ko pa yung author. This is a story, a fictional story, of a young boy artist who was commissioned to make a crucible, a container for the cup that Jesus used during the Last Supper. At bakit isang artist ang kinomission? Because he had to carve from silver the faces of the 12 apostles and Jesus himself. So the challenge was to go around the Mediterranean, kasi hindi niya nakita yung mga apostles, to be able to meet the apostles in their mission areas and to be able to carve their faces on silver. And the greatest challenge, of course, is how to carve the face of Jesus, who is already resurrected in heaven or ascended in heaven. Di ko na ikukwento kung paano niya nagawa yan. Naalala ko lang, kasi on that fictional story, which has a lot of historical aspects to it, ang nag-commission doon sa bata, according to the novel, was Saint Luke himself. As we celebrate the Feast of Saint Luke, hindi na iba ang kanyang life project. He was a physician, but then he became a follower of Christ. He was not of the original 12 apostles, but he was so instrumental to our knowledge of Jesus because Saint Luke wrote the gospel, one of the four gospels, and wrote about the early church in the book Acts of the Apostles. May mga doktor na mamaya naging businessman, may mga doktor na nag-artista o naging singer, may mga doktor na nagpare at madre. They have a lot of reasons for this career change. But we focus on Saint Luke. He did not actually change career, but he intensified his focus after encountering and knowing Jesus. It became his life project to tell the world about Jesus. And not contented by telling or preaching about Jesus during his lifetime, he at many times sat down and wrote as much as he could about the life of Jesus so that we in our generation will get to encounter Jesus through the gospel. Very similar dun sa ating fictional story, naging life project nung bata ang hanapin hindi lang mga mukha ng mga apostol, yung mukha ni Jesus sa kanyang buhay. Dear friends, I believe the life and life project of Saint Luke speaks to all of us. Sa mga may bagong pamilya, sa mga may bagong apo, sa may mga bagong trabaho, sa mga kaka-retire pa lamang, sa mga dumadaan sa krisis, sa mga nagkakaroon ng crossroads sa ating mga buhay. St. Luke shows us that his life project in whatever he does was to find Christ and speak about Christ. His truth, his goodness, his grace, his presence in our lives. Inuulit ko sa mga may bagong apo, sa mga may bagong pinagdaraanan, sa mga gumising sa isang magandang umaga, sa mga nag-change ng career, sa mga mas tumututok sa kanilang ginagawa. St. Luke invites us to follow in his footsteps by emphasizing a focus on Christ. Masayang ginawa ni St. Luke ang pagpapalaganap tungkol sa buhay ni Kristo. Ang dasal natin naway magampanan din natin, makuha natin yung parehong kasiyahan sa pagpapalaganap ng mensahe ni Kristo in the particular vocations that we have all been given.